Who wants to talk about Spider-Man coming to PS4? I sure do.
Me too.
That's right. And we've got Brian from Insomniac Games, and we've got Bill from Marble Publishing. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having us.
It's great to be here.
This is incredible. Spidey brought the house down last night. Was sort of the penultimate moment in the big PlayStation press conference, and man, I think it's the one that was this one's been trending for like the last like 16 hours.
It's I tweeted last night. It was like kind of a childhood dream come true.
And yeah.
It's like, it's pretty amazing. I still like can't believe we're actually making a Spider-Man game.
I could just as easily sit here and watch this trailer again than talk to you, but I have to keep the show going.
So. Okay, all right.
So Bill, tell me, Marvel, PlayStation, Insomniac, Spider-Man, all together. It seems like a winning combination.
It's amazing that, you know, we waited for the planets to align. This I think Spider-Man represents a new beginning, a new era for Marvel Games. This is going to be the most ambitious game yet that we've done, and we wanted to wait till we had the perfect partnership, and that happened when Insomniac and Sony came together, and we just couldn't be more excited to really set the bar for all the Spider-Man fans, so that Spidey could swing right over that bar.
Oh, nice.
That was very good.
Poetic.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, it's just been a dream journey. Like, I remember, you know, when I first kind of heard about this rumblings in the office, I went into Ted's office, who was our owner, and he goes, so what do you think about, you know, working with Sony and Marvel? And I just said, like, well, of course we got to do it. And I was begging him. I'm like, we got to do this. And I said, oh, by the way, I'd really like to be the creative director on this project. And, you know, he agreed, thank God. And it's just been a whirlwind since. I mean, to keep this under wraps for so long has been like, I've been waiting for that yesterday. Just, I mean, I think we all in Sonic have been waiting for that moment just to finally say, okay, it's here. I can say Spider-Man in public, finally.
I know. And I mean, look at this animation, though. I want to point this out. Obviously, Insomniac Games has a very proud legacy with Ratchet & Clank, Sunset Overdrive, a number of great games over a long, long time. It feels like the culmination of everything you guys have been working on.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think there's a lot of elements that we're bringing to all our different games, whether it's our world building, whether it's, you know, traversal, which we did a lot of in Sunset Overdrive. Taking those lessons we learned and injecting them into Spider-Man. Art, the humor that we've had in Ratchet, bring it, you know, that's a big part of the Spider-Man character, and making sure, you know, in working with Bill and, you know, Mike Jones, our executive producer over Marvel, making sure that we're being really true to the character. But at the same time, taking, you know, mixing things up, that's what we want to make sure that people understand that, yes, we want to be really respectful of the franchise, but at the same time, we want to surprise people at the same time.
So we're just going to keep running this trailer over and over because it looks great. Yeah. I told the producers, just keep looping the trailer. That's all people want to see. But I'm told there are a number of Easter eggs in this trailer.
Yeah.
If you watch through, they're planted. They're there very quick, but they are there.
Yes.
And I think it gives a hint of the storytelling that infuses every stage of the game. When you talk about Insomniac and Marvel, it's all about storytelling. And that is at the heart of everything we do, and that is especially true, and it's been crystallized here with Spider-Man in this game. So yeah, there are Easter eggs, and they all speak to the story of the game.
Oh.
Yeah, and I think, like, you know, if you look at, you know, whether it's the films, the you know, the Netflix series, when they announce something, there's always a little something for everybody, and we wanted to make sure that we did that our job as well, in, like, you know, giving people things to talk about and speculate on, and, you know, there's nuggets here and there that definitely, if you've been watching the trailer and scrubbing through it, you can find some pretty cool stuff.
And I think all that comes from what you said earlier about childhood dream.
Yeah.
The funniest thing was last week,
we
were at the offices, because the Marvel Games office is like 10 minutes away from the Insomniac office. So we're there back and forth. And we were there the last time, and we were having lunch, and we're all sitting around.
Great.
And we all just started talking about, what was it, a comic book? Was it a cartoon?
When did
you first see
Marvel Spidey? Memories,
did you have,
called it. Yeah.
We busted out the underoos, like, I had those.
Yeah.
And we all talked about our childhood memories, and everyone at the table all began at an extremely early age and are lifelong fans of the character, and that is what everyone is pouring into the game. It's like, we're remembering who we were back then and saying, I wish I could do that, and now we're doing it.
There's 20, 30 years of a pent-up interest here that you're pouring into this game.
Yeah. And, you know, it's just, you know, we understand how important this character is to a lot of people. It's important to us, myself, everybody at Insomniac. And we just want to do it justice. I think that's the thing is we just want to make sure that people walk away unbelievably happy. And this is kind of the first taste of that journey that we're going to be going on.
So far, so good based on what I'm seeing in social media, based on what I'm hearing. So I know I'm not going to grill you guys too hard because I know it's early days on this game.
Yeah.
Couple details though I do want to sort out up front. So this is not related to any of the cinematic stuff that's going on right now, right?
It's standalone. I think we've been inspired by everything that you
100%.
Said, all the different mediums that Marvel has, whether it's film, animation, live action, comic books, even like just years of, you know, hey, t-shirts, what does
Amazing
Spider-Man
shirt.
Mean? So we're looking at everything and we're blending it all together, but it's standalone.
Yep.
All new story, all new world. You know, we want everyone involved in this to tell their story.
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's about respecting the traditions of the franchise, but mixing things up. It's that blending, and I mean, honestly, that's the thing that I've been so surprised with, but like also just so excited about that. You know, working with Bill and Mike and everybody at Marvel, going like, well, can we try this? Sure. What, like, just having we have a lot of freedom, and you know, and that's been a surprise. I mean, you know, I've never worked on, you know, like a Marvel, Spider-Man, or any licensed product before, and just being able to have that freedom and crafting this unique universe.
I think that's
it's
I'm
been
glad
awesome.
To hear that. I'm glad to hear that.
We do like these guys a lot.
It's ingrained. Like when you're at Marvel, when you're brought up through Marvel. It's ingrained in us we are a creator-friendly company, and when we are lucky enough to work with people of such great talent, we want them to do what they do.
Yep.
So I remember on the comic book side, we would hire in writers and artists, and we would say, what is your vision? How can I help you express your vision?
Yep.
Now, we are caretakers, if you will, of the brand, but the Marvel brand, we're always stretching, we're always challenging, we're always moving the characters forward, so it's just ingrained in us to work with the best, help them tell their vision, experiment, put it out there, and let them like live your fantasy.
So if you ever want to get excited about Marvel, talk to this guy for like 5 minutes.
I'm
How
so
can
fired
you not
up.
Me?
I remember the first conversation I ever had with Bill. I just sat there and I took about 7 pages of notes within an hour. And one thing that he said right off the bat that I still to this day talk about, he goes, the best stories are when Peter's world and Spider-Man worlds collide.
Mm.
And we have taken that and
awesome.
Just throughout every day of this development, we have, are we hitting that? And that's, you know, being able to have access to, you know, Bill and Mike and everybody at Marvel and just like saying, are we doing that the right way? You know, and then them asking us, you know, from the development side, how we can tell that story. It's been, like I said, it's been a fun, I mean, even just from the design of the suit, you know, having that flexibility to try something a little different.
I think it's my favorite suit out of them
thank
all.
You. Thank you.
Awesome.
Out of them all.
We like that.
There's
people.
I know people have questions about it.
Yeah.
And we will answer them.
Yeah.
There are answers for everything.
Yeah.
And again, it all comes down to love of the character and telling our own story.
Yeah.
And there is thought put into every aspect of the game. And there is definite thought put into that awesome suit right there.
We ask the question why a lot to ourselves. Like, well, why are we doing this? How does it tie into the universe? How does it tie into our main character? What's the ramp like cause and effect? We're always talking about that because we want everything to be buttoned up and, you know, we talk a lot about cohesive, being a cohesive package. I feel like that's what makes a great video game, a great story. We don't want it to, you know, extend ourselves just because we want to fulfill that. We want to make sure everything feels really cohesive because that's what Marvel does really, really well.
We know that a few things about the title. We know that Peter Parker's a little older in this one.
More experienced, for sure.
A little more experienced,
Yeah.
Now, how does that, you know, how does that influence things?
I think it's from, you know, the way he moves around the city. From, you know, you saw that scene of him, you know, running through that coffee shop. You know, parkour. You know, more. Our swinging is just going to be more than just swinging through. You know, you saw that shots of the city. Want him, you know, flesh out his traversal set. So definitely going to see more of that. But just the way he fights, it's going to be more of an experienced, you know, someone who's been doing this for more than a couple of years. So we definitely want to make sure that his fighting style reflects that, for sure.
And go ahead, Bill. Sorry.
I was going to say, as you say, everything that he does, he's you see that he's learned, he's experienced, he's really mastering his skills. And, you know, as Stan said, what Marvel does is put the human in the superhuman.
Mm-hmm.
So like us, we learn from our experiences.
Yeah.
Hopefully we grow, we learn from them, we get better, and we just wanted to think, we're always thinking, what would Peter do? What would Peter do? And put ourselves in his wall-crawling shoes.
Yeah.
And he learns, he gets better.
Whenever I talk to the team or talk to Bill and Mike, or, you know, we talk a lot about Peter Parker. For us, Peter is as integral as Spider-Man. We talk a lot about the story, telling the story of the man behind the mask.
Like, yeah.
To us, Peter's as important as the Spider-Man character. We really want to make sure that, and I think that's what, whether it's the comics, the animation, whether it's live action, like, they're always telling, it's more than just about the guy in the suit or the woman in the suit. It's the person. Again, a really human story.
Marvel always does a great job. You think of the films as you meet the characters before they get their powers.
Yeah.
You fall in love with them.
Yeah.
And they get the powers, and that just makes their life more complicated and interesting. And so you care about him up there on swinging through the rooftops because you care about Peter.
Yeah.
And it's all connected.
See, I told you he's really good at this.
I got to read some Spider-Man right now.
Yes!
Yes, you do.
That's awesome. So we're almost out of time, but I was hoping I could, I know, again, it's very early days, but from like a mechanics perspective, like any kind of abilities, anything like that, are there some new things we're going to see Spider-Man do here?
I think we're gonna push him in some areas, whether it's traversal, whether it's fighting, whether it's just open world exploration. We're gonna be really tapping into everything. You know, Peter's a really smart guy.
Yeah.
How does that tie into not just, you know, his life as Peter Parker, but when he brings it to the fight? So we definitely want to tap into, you know, he's a really smart dude. How does that play out when you're actually playing the game, when he's in the suit?
Spider-Man at his full potential, at his full power.
Yes.
That's 100%, awesome.
Yes.
I am super sold. Spider-Man's coming to PS4. Do we have a name for this thing yet, or is it just sort of Spider-Man right now?
Spider-Man for right now.
Spider-Man for right now. All right. Well, that works for me.
Thank you.
You guys,
I was going to say, follow the hashtag on Twitter.
Yep.
Follow us on Twitter. And as the months come, we'll be talking more and more about
the entire game. We have a lot more to talk about.
I'm sure you do. I am sure you do. Guys, it's been awesome talking here about
Thank
Spider-Man.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, I mean, clearly one of the big highlights last night for PlayStation's E3 press conference. The crowd went nuts. I mean, what did you think of that show, by the way?
I have to say, I've been to 16 or 17 E3s, and that was probably one of the best press conferences I've ever gone to. You know, the Sony staff did an amazing job.
It was just game after game.
And that orchestra.
And the men's chorus.
That was awesome.
And the woman over there on the drum.
Awesome.
And then everything that was descending.
Yeah.
And it was
great.
Crazy cool.
I love going to those press conferences. And that was a hell of an experience.
Hell of a show.
That's awesome. So, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Spider-Man, it's on the lips of every gamer, I think, across the world. PlayStation.